the clear blue eastern sky, comes Sky King, brought to you of this store.
This is it, boss.
Okay, do we leave the car here?
Nah, the house is about a mile up the road.
Mind that, Ma. I'll get a strap.
Nail.
Hiya, Mac. You didn't think you could run out on me that easy, did you?
How'd you know I was here?
You weren't hard to trace.
I'm not coming back.
I hired you to engrave some plates for a $20 bill. You didn't finish the job.
I sent back your money.
Not all of it.
So I owe you some dough. I'll pay you. Look, Neil, I let you talk me into that deal because I lost my job. I was angry and broke. Ma needed the dough, and I...
Any better off now?
Well, at least I'm no counterfeiter.
I've got two unfinished plates here that says you are. You know, if somebody were to turn these plates over to the feds, you'd go to the pen so fast you wouldn't know what hit you.
What are you driving at?
Engraving's like handwriting, ain't it? They could trace it right to you.
I was working for you.
You couldn't prove it.
Why, you dirty blackmailer. Suppose I decide to take my chances with the law.
You won't. Your mother's health ain't been so good lately. And if you went to jail, that wouldn't help things. In fact, it could get worse awful quick.
So that's it.
Yeah. You gonna play ball?
I have much choice, have I?
Suckers never do. Come on, let's get out of here.
No, wait. Ma's going away. She'll think something's wrong if I don't see her off.
When's she gone?
A friend's picking her up right away. I can leave right after that.
Okay, Mac. But don't try to run out on me again, huh?
You've pretty well covered that, haven't you? Let me do that.
Well, I was beginning to think you had deserted me.
You know better than that.
Alan.
Yes, Ma?
Is anything wrong?
Well, no, Ma. What gave you that idea? There. That ought to hold it.
Maybe I better not go away. You won't have been
home. Now, listen to me. You're going to visit Sis and the kids, and you're not going to worry about me. Understand?
I guess all mothers worry about their sons.
Well, don't overdo it. You need a good long rest, and I'm going to make sure. There's Sky now. Get your things, Ma. Hurry up. We mustn't keep him waiting.
Well, you seem to be glad to get rid of me.
Maybe I am at that.
Hello, Sky. Awfully kind of you driving me to the station like this.
Not at all, Mrs. McNeil. We're glad to do it.
And you keep an eye on Alan for me, won't you?
I promise.
And don't you let things pile up in the kitchen too much.
When Penny gets back from the East, I'll have her make a weekly inspection.
You better get going, Sky.
Goodbye, Ma. Have a nice visit and take good care of yourself.
Goodbye, son.
Sure you won't come with us to the station?
Too much to do around here, thanks.
Mac, how long's your old lady gonna be gone?
About a month.
Oh, great. Then we'll set up our branch of the Mint right here.
No, you can't barge.
Oh, shut up. I'm giving the orders around here. How are you coming on that second plate?
I don't know. The Bureau uses a special geometric lathe for these whorls. You just can't duplicate them by hand.
Well, you do as good a job on Jackson as you did on the White House, and we'll have a 20 that'll pass. Nobody really looks at money anyway.
Banks do.
We're not passing them in banks. Satch, you get down to the airport. Lefty's bringing that stuff in on that 12 o'clock plane.
Okay, boss. Hello, Penny.
Hello, Skye. Hi, Clifford.
Hi, sis.
Gosh, it's great to be home.
Oh, it's great having you back, Penny. Did you have a good time?
Well, I'll say.
How was the flight?
Oh, fine. Gee, I have so much to tell you, I don't know where to begin. Did you miss me?
Well, we finally got used to the peace and quiet, if that's what you mean.
I'll ignore that. Oh, how's Mrs. McNeil? You wrote she was sick.
Well, she's fine now. I'll tell you all about her while Clipper gets you back. As a matter of fact, she's so well that we put her on the train.
Hey, wait a minute. That's...
Well, I'm glad Mrs. McNeil's well enough to travel. I guess Alan's coming home is what did it.
Of course.
Well, let's get going. It's 18 minutes after lunchtime already.
Honestly, Clifford, can't you ever think of anything but food?
Hiya, Neil.
Did you get it?
Yeah, no trouble at all.
Let me see it.
Okay. I went to five or six banks so nobody would ask questions. I didn't want anyone to...
Hey, what's this junk?
I don't know, boss.
What are you trying to pull?
Nothing, boss. I had the stuff and I left KC. Somebody must have switched suitcases.
If you're on the level, you fell for one of the oldest gags and... Hey, what's this? Penny King.
Penny.
You know her?
No, I thought I did.
Hey, wait a minute. That guy that took your mother to the station. Named King, wasn't it?
Well, yes, but that doesn't
mean... I remember now. There was a gal on the plane the pilot called Penny. She got off here.
All right, Max, spill it. Where does she live? Come on, talk.
At the next ranch, but she's just a kid.
You go over and pick up that suitcase.
I know about this man, King. If he finds out what's in that suitcase, he'll want answers to a lot of questions.
The gal ain't unpacked yet. How'll he know?
Can't risk it, and we can't risk a stick-up either.
Then what do we do?
You're going over to the King's place, and Mac here is going with you.
No. I'm not going to mix Penny up in any dirty, rotten...
Shut up! I'm telling you what to do. You're going over to the King's place. And when you get there, here's what you're going to do.
That's another reason I'm glad to be home. I'd hate to live in a big city like New York.
Well, a lot of people in big cities would hate to live out here, Penny.
Didn't anybody else want any more of this?
Haven't you had enough yet?
I'm a growing boy.
Well, I'm not going to sit here and watch you grow. I've got to unpack. May I be excused, Scott?
Certainly, Penny.
It's been so long since I've had my jeans on, I'm going to frighten myself.
How about a judo lesson, Sky?
Oh, it's too soon after lunch, Clipper.
Well, it's just as important you know how to fight on a full stomach as it is an empty one.
Yes, but your stomach's never empty.
That's what I mean. Now's as good a time as any.
Sometimes I wonder how I get talked into these things.
Come on.
All right, now we'll see how much you remember from your last lesson.
Okay.
Remember to keep your eye on me all the time now.
Yeah, I know.
You ready?
Yeah.
Back off.
Oh, not again.
Judo works both ways, you know.
Yeah, and either way, I end up flat on my back.
You didn't watch me closely. I saw the hold you were going to try, so I just shifted my weight.
Feels more like you shifted mine.
All right, let's try it again. And this time, watch me.
All right. Get ready. Here I come.
Guy! What in the world?
Sky's giving me a judo lesson. I see what you mean about keeping your eye on the other guy.
Sometimes you learn a little too fast, Clipper.
Sky, this suitcase is full of money.
What?
I thought I was crazy too, but look.
For Pete's sake.
What'd you do, rob a bank?
I had to break the lock to get it open. I thought the catch was only jammed.
Where'd you get this, Penny?
Well, I don't know.
Hey, you know, there was another suitcase at the airport just like this one. Maybe that guy got yours by mistake.
Then he's the bank robber.
I don't think it's robbery.
Why not?
Well, these are all brand new ones. Why would anybody just steal $1 bills?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe they...
They're counterfeit. That man's a counterfeiter.
No, they're not counterfeit.
How do you know?
Counterfeit money's easy to spot.
Well, maybe a clever counterfeit.
There are no counterfeiters this clever. See how clear and sharp these lines are?
Uh-huh.
On counterfeit, they'd be blurred and irregular.
You'd have to have awful good eyes to notice that.
And take the paper. That's what gives away most counterfeiters. See all these little blue silk threads? Feel the paper itself. It's three quarters linen and one quarter cotton, and nobody but the government can make it. Anybody else would have to set up his own paper mill.
Gosh.
You know, if people would learn about money and then really look at it, there wouldn't be any counterfeiters.
Well, if it isn't counterfeit and it hasn't been stolen, what is it?
I'll check with the sheriff. Maybe the man who took your suitcase is already called in.
This is close enough.
I won't be able to sit down for a month.
Hitch up to that bush there.
If I get off, I will get back on this animal.
You can mount from those rocks. Over there to the right. You can sneak around through those bushes.
Suppose the door is locked.
Out here, folks trust one another. All set?
Yeah. Take it easy, you dope.
We want it to look good, don't we?
Why, you...
I guess that's good enough.
I'll get back at you for this, you double-crossing.
Quit griping. It's what Nail wanted, isn't it? Go on, get going. Yes. All right, Sheriff. We'll keep it here till you've checked with the airport.
What'd he say, Sky?
There haven't been any robberies, and nobody's reported the loss of a suitcase full of $1 bills.
If nobody claims the money, then it's mine, isn't it?
Oh, I don't know, Penny. I wouldn't count on it.
Help! Sky! Help! Help!
Come on. Over by the shed.
Why, it's Alan McNeil. Get some water, Penny.
Was he shot?
I don't think so. They just knocked unconscious.
Gosh, nobody around here would...
Take it easy, Alan. Huh. You'll be all right in a minute.
Here's the water.
Put some on his forehead.
What in the world happened?
I don't know. From the looks of the way this ground is torn up, there was a heck of a fight.
Who would he be fighting with?
Feeling better?
Yeah, I'm all right.
What happened to you?
Well, I rode over to borrow a pound of coffee, and I saw this man standing over there.
Did you recognize him?
I never saw him before, but he was acting, well, kind of sneaky. I went over to see what he was up to, and he pulled a gun on me. I tried to take it away from him, and we got in a fight.
Gosh, I wonder who he was.
Never mind that now. You think you can stand up?
Yeah, I'm okay.
You sure you're all right?
Yeah, I'm okay now.
What about a little coffee?
No, thanks.
We might have known things to start popping as soon as Penny gets back. Mysterious prowlers, suitcases full of money. Well, if I had a nick... Huh?
I mean, I don't understand.
Penny, she's got a whole suitcase full of dollar bills. Come here, I'll show you. Hey, it's gone.
Gone?
Yeah.
But how could it?
We've been outsmarted.
But how?
The prowler. He must have traded suitcases while we were all outside.
But if the money was his, why couldn't he come up and ask for it?
That's one of the things that bothers me. I better phone the sheriff.
No, wait. I mean,
Hadn't I better talk to him? I can describe the man.
That's why I'm calling him.
Oh.
Did you get the right suitcase?
Yeah, get me down. Oh, splitting in two.
That's the best I can do, Sheriff. All right, I'll tell him. He's sending out a description.
Good.
Can't we trail him ourselves?
The ground's too hard for prints, and he must be miles away by now.
Why would anybody bring a suitcase full of dollar bills to Grover in the first place?
That's one of the many questions we can't answer yet.
Well, if there's nothing else I can do, I'll be getting home.
You feel up to riding?
Sure. Don't bother to come out with me.
If he's caught, you'll have to identify him, you know.
Yeah. I'll be around.
What's the matter, Sky?
What kind of an engraving job did Alan have?
Oh, he worked for a company that printed bonds and stock certificates, fancy stuff like that.
Well, I'm going to unpack.
Don't touch that handle, Penny.
Huh?
I'm going to take this suitcase to Phoenix and check with the FBI.
The FBI?
Fingerprints, you dope.
Well, can we go with you?
It'll just be routine. You two better stay here.
Well, guy, Sky,
I'll be back in a couple of hours.
All right.
Yeah. How's this?
Swell.
It's an awful expensive way to get paper.
Paper's important. Most people judge money by feeling it.
Watching that chemical make dough disappear gives me the creeps.
When Lefty gets through printing this, it'll be worth 20 bucks instead of one. That's 1,900% profit. What took you so long?
They'd opened the suitcase. The sheriff knows, too.
Well, I ain't scared of no hick, Sheriff.
Yeah, but Sky's no hick. He may start putting two and two together.
Well, that don't mean he'll connect you with anything.
Listen, I'm in this to stay out of jail. I say we better clear out.
What you say don't count, Mac.
You don't know Sky. I do.
All right, if that's the way you want it. Satch will stand guard outside. Go on, Satch. If you want us out of here, you just finish up on old man Jackson. Lefty and me is gonna start printing a White House sign.
What are you doing?
Alan forgot the coffee he wanted to borrow. I'm gonna ride over with it.
Well, don't be gone long. Sky, I'll be back soon.
Oh, I won't. The man on the plane.
Pretty good, don't it?
Yeah. Unless you had a magnifying glass, you couldn't tell it from real.
Where do you think you're going?
I was bringing some coffee for Mr. McNeil.
Then let's take it in to him.
Hey, what's the idea of bringing her in here?
I found her outside, peeking through the door.
Penny! Why did you head her off? Now we are in a jam.
You'll be in a worse one if you don't let me go.
Penny, this isn't my fault. They forced me to...
Shut up.
They'll come looking for her when she don't show up.
Yeah, I know. Load this stuff in the car. We're clearing out of here.
What about her?
She stays here.
But she'll blab.
She won't get moving.
I don't know what you're planning to do, but if it involves harming this kid, you better plan different.
Are you telling me what to do?
Yes. And if you want your plates finished, you better listen. Nothing happens to Penny, understand?
Noble all of a sudden, ain't you?
I've groveled and been afraid of you long enough.
Oh, relax. I'm just going to tie the kid up so we can make a clean getaway.
All right. But don't get any other ideas.
All right, Satch, tie her up here.
Hello, Flying Crown Ranch. Hello, Flying Crown Ranch. This is the Songbird. Over.
Flying Crown Ranch, this is Clipper speaking. Go ahead, Sky.
Hello, Clipper. Coming in for a landing. Phone the sheriff and tell him to meet us at McNeil Road.
McNeil Road? Over.
That's right. Alan's fingerprints were on the suitcase, along with the prints of a counterfeiter named Lefty Grogan. Over.
Sky. Pay me to the McNeil place now.
How long's she been gone?
About a half an hour.
After you call the sheriff, get our guns and bring the car out on the field to meet me. And hurry.
Wilco.
Roger and out.
What are you doing with that straw?
Nothing. Go get in the car.
A candle. You were going to start a fire.
What if I was? If she talks, we all go to jail.
I said nothing was going to happen to her.
I'm fixing it so the fire don't start till after we're out of here. They can't pin anything on us. I've been waiting to do this.
That kid ain't gonna trouble us anymore.
What made you suspect Alan?
I kept wondering why he was so nervous. Then I remembered he was an engraver.
Yes, Guy, but...
doctoring $1 bills is an old counterfeiting trick. I played a hunch and it paid off.
How come the FBI had Alan's fingerprints? He'd never been arrested before, has he?
We got lefties from the FBI. Alan's came from the War Department. Oh. He was in the Army, you know.
I got it. Can't you go any faster, Sky?
Doing the best I can, Clipper.
I don't like this, boss.
Quit worrying. When that candle burns down to the straw, this place is going up like it was gunpowder.
Can't we take her with us instead?
What, and have every cop in the country on our tail? You stupid.
I don't like getting mixed up in that killing.
Oh, wait outside.
Give me a match, Lefty.
Get down so they won't see you and be careful. We don't know how many we're up against.
Grab his shoulders. This kid's gonna finish those plates if I have to break every bone in his body.
Hey, boss. King's driving up the road.
Is he alone?
Yeah.
Well, the three of us ought to be able to take care of him. Get out of sight. Get your hands up.
Quite a gang of you, isn't there?
Cut the smart cracks. Get over by the kid.
Where's McNeil? I expected him on this welcoming committee.
He ain't feeling so good.
So I see. Which one of you is Lefty Grogan?
How'd you...
Shut up! How did you know that name?
I know quite a bit about this counterfeiting gang. So does the FBI.
But the feds...
You're lying. The FBI ain't got a thing on us.
Grogan's fingerprints were all over that suitcase he brought back.
Oh, no. We gotta get out of here, boss.
Not before we take care of these two.
You're gonna get caught eventually. Wouldn't you rather be arrested for counterfeiting than for murder?
Nobody's arresting me for anything. Tie him up. Clipper!
I think under the circumstances, the judge will be lenient.
He ought to be. Alan tried to protect me.
He saved my life.
That's right, Alan. All three of us are pulling for you.
Cut the sob story. He made a plate, didn't he?
Only because you forced him to.
Bunk. This whole deal was his idea. He just made a grandstand play when he got caught.
That's not true.
Can you prove different?
Sure. Did you take a good look at that bill you printed from his plate?
What about it?
Allen never wanted the counterfeiting scheme to work. That's why he left the new balcony off the White House.
The balcony?
That's right, Neil. Even counterfeiters ought to look at the money they get.